Shout out to Shakara right now, rocking with On the Run, man. Yeah, Hylan Starr.
Hey, what's up? It's your girl Shakara, and you already know you are now tuned into On the Run, and with me, I got Hylan Starr.
Yeah, Hylan Starr was sending.
Yeah, so first of all, rounds. Over 2 million views.
Okay, yeah.
Congratulations. But do you ride all night? We can go rounds for rounds, rounds for rounds. We go. That was incredible. So, did you anticipate that type of success?
Actually, I hated that song from the day that I heard it.
What?
Yeah, it was actually a demo. I didn't want to do the song. I told my CEO, I told my team, I said, hey, I do not like this song. I do not want to put this song out. This is not for me. And of course, you know, I still had to go with the team. And luckily I did, because now it charted the top 20, you know, at radio, and it has 4 million views at this moment.
Wow, mm-hmm. Incredible. So what was it about Rounds initially when you heard it that you were like, I don't know?
I think that it was just the fact that I just never really liked the way it sounded. But like, I feel like once it came out and like I started performing it, I started seeing the reaction on people's faces and like them really like liking the record, I was like, okay, maybe I don't know. You know, maybe I don't know.
So that music video too, you had like a scene in the backseat. Was that your first type of scene like that?
I wouldn't say yeah. No, it wasn't.
Okay.
I mean, not, you know, in real life, of course, you know.
But, right.
I've definitely had those type of scenes in real life, you know, but in the music video, yeah.
Yeah, because I'm like, on camera it's totally different. Was there anything that you learned from that experience that you was like, okay, now I know for next time? Because I'm like, it's so different on camera versus, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like I learned some things, you know, of course, how to work the camera a little better, you know, from that video, you know, the video we dropped on March 4th, Don't Make Me Beg, featuring Lil Baby. That video is amazing. So,
yes.
Hey, I'm just letting y'all, putting y'all down. So go check that out.
Nah, that's what's up. Yo, I can't wait to hear that, because that was actually one of my questions. I was like, is it possible there's a collab with Lil Baby? So, okay, that was great.
Sure.
Yes, okay. So what is it like being working with these type of artists now? Like,
It's lit. It's everything that I expected.
Yeah.
You know? I put a lot of work in to get here, so it like, a lot of the stuff don't really faze me, you know? Because, like, I knew this day was going to come, because I really, like, worked very hard to get here, you know? Really selling my CDs from, like, really, you know, trying to figure it out, you know, like, not having no direction, just going, taking a leap out on faith.
Yeah, I heard about that,
okay,
right?
Okay.
You were selling your music,
mm-hmm.
And I have to know, did you have any doubts at all? Because the quota you set was kind of high, 300? Like, I see you, but, you know, did you ever go through that? And if so, how did you overcome it?
I mean, you know, it was some days that I didn't sell 30 CDs. You know, I sold 20, or I might have sold 15. But I just looked at it like this, man. You know, anything is better than $60 a day for 8 hours. You know what I mean? These jobs pay you $10 an hour, and you working 8 hours a day, so you're making $80. Like, what is that? If I sell 8 CDs, I can make that. And I know, like I said, that less than an hour.
That's a good point. Like, that's one thing I wanted to know for you as a music artist. I know you always knew you knew how to sing, right?
Right, right.
But when did you know I'm going to take this serious?
I feel like it was after the fact that I went viral for the first time. When I did my remix to Lifestyle. And, like, I got 2 million views in, like, 2 days. But I feel like it was just the working up to that point. You know, mm-hmm. I think I dropped, like, 200 videos. They got 100 views, 200 views, 300 views. You know, I really built that up. And then I posted one, and it just shot. It shot through the roof, and I just kept building off of that. But after that moment, I was like, yo, I take this seriously.
Wow, that's incredible. So school was never, like, something that crossed your mind? It was just like, no, it's music.
Nah, school. And I mean, I did graduate high school, but college, yeah. I got that college check, and I got that loan.
Nah, I respect it. So wait, was it after your music went viral that you started working with people like Sean Garrett? Like, tell me about
so,
the timeline.
So basically, okay, so my video went viral. I kept doing cover videos just to keep that momentum and keep myself in people's faces and just really just continue to grow. It wasn't until I decided to leave my hometown, you know, drop everything and just leave and just start selling my CDs in Atlanta, Georgia, was whenever I was like, okay, now I might be able to get somewhere, you know, because it's a lot of opportunity in Atlanta. You never know who I could be singing to. You never know who I could be selling a CD to. You just never really know, you know what I'm saying? So, and keep in mind, people don't have CD players at all. So I literally was selling CDs to people with no CD players and all of that. But they rocked with my grind so hard that they still supported what I had going on. You know what I'm saying? But it wasn't until I really signed my deal. Wolfpack Global Music. Shout out to my big homie, man. Appreciate you for giving me this opportunity. But yeah, like, yeah, it wasn't until I signed my deal and I started working with the big names and stuff.
Right, definitely. So when you were singing on the street, because I do want to go back to that a little bit, how much were you singing, like, to make people buy CDs with no CD player?
I would literally just walk up and out of nowhere just sing. I mean, like, I would just walk up and just sing a cover. I just walk up to him, gold jewelry shining so bright. You know what I'm saying? Like, I would just like just sing like a record that I recorded on the tape and be like, yo, I did this record, I did that record, I did that record. And I just wanted to know if you wouldn't mind supporting my grind and really just, you know, just support what I got going on. I do this for a living. Mm-hmm. And people would be like, oh my God, your voice is so amazing. I wouldn't mind hearing more. And then they would just buy it.
Wow. That is
incredible. I wouldn't say hi. I would just walk up and start singing.
And you probably catch up. And they probably like rush into it. And they probably just like, oh wait, that was him?
Yeah. Hold
on, and then they stop, right?
It just surprised them. Catch them off guard.
What's the craziest moment you had? Like, that could be with fans or just in general.
What is the craziest moment I had? I feel like it was whenever I was singing in Walmart. I was singing my song Fool, and I walked up to somebody and I sung Fool to them, and their daughter was there, and like she said, "No, leave me alone, leave me alone. No, leave us alone. We're good. That's probably one of the craziest moments.
Oh wow! So did you sing for the person and everything changed?
Like I literally tried to sing for him like I normally do for everybody else. And most of the time people are like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Okay. But this particular person was like, no, get away from us. Leave us alone. It was one of those things.
Wow, that's crazy. But yeah, that's good for people out there to understand that it happens to everybody.
Yeah,
you
for
just
sure.
Have to keep going.
Yeah, like, you know, everybody's not going to like you. Everybody's not going to like your talent. You know, it's your job to keep pushing and keep striving. And just don't never stop, like, just go.
I'm glad you said that, because one thing I always hear is when you get closer and closer to success, that breaking point, that's when you want to give up the most.
Mm-hmm.
Did you go through a period like that where you was like, dang, if I would have let that stop me,
definitely,
I would have never had it?
Definitely. You know, I, a lot of my family members tried to get me not to quit my job. I'm like, man, listen, I got something big on my mind. You know, I lost my mother along the journey. My mother passed away. Fourth stage lung cancer. You know, I watched my brother get murdered, you know, in my face. Like, I've been through a lot. You know, at a young age, I was homeless with my mom, sleeping under a bridge. You know what I'm saying? So, like, I feel like the depth of your struggle determines your success.
Wow. Now, that's a lot. And the fact that you kept going to pursue music. So, do they motivate you? Like, do you sometimes say, like, I did this for y'all?
For sure. My brother always used to tell me, like, man, you're gonna be a superstar. You know, you're gonna be a superstar. At the time, you know, I was just having fun singing as a child. But you know, now I can truly say, like, now it has came to life. You know what I'm saying? What he was talking about, like, years ago.
Yeah, he always seen it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's incredible.
Yeah,
and it seems like you always knew too.
Yeah, man. You know, I always believed in myself more than anybody, man. Like I believed in myself more than anybody. I feel like that's the biggest thing. Like, even whenever you feel like it's not gonna work, whenever you feel like it's you know what I'm saying? Like, cause it do get hard. Like, you know, like, you got people. I got a child, so you know, just think about me. I'm selling CDs with a child. Like, people are like, bro, are you crazy? But I always had a bigger vision. I always knew that this day was gonna come. You know what I'm saying? And all I had to do is just stay on that path and just keep going, no matter who says stop. My dad didn't believe in me. He thought I should go work in an oil field. And then nobody really see the vision but me. And I'm so glad that I did. Because because now we got a song dropping. You know what I'm saying? March 4th, Don't Make Me Big, featuring Lil Baby, man. The new R&B nigga has arrived.
Yo, and I just want to say it's a real talent that you, when you sing and I listen to it, I feel what you're saying. And right. That's hard, you know, for artists to do nowadays. Mm-hmm. So for you, and I can't wait to hear this record, by the way, like, Don't Make Me Beg. I already have an idea of what the song might be about, but I'm going to ask you that after. But yeah, I want to know, like, what is that technique? What do you do to make people, like, connect with people in your music? That's hard.
I mean, I feel like, it really just be about, like, for people to feel you, you have to, like, have something inside of you. Like, it has to be, like, first of all, you gotta feel it. You know what I'm saying? But, like, at the same time, I'm not gonna say, like, just going through the most fucked up shit, like, is gonna help you be able to project that onto the world. But at the end, but at the same time, like, you gotta be able to go through shit so you'll know what pain feel like, so you can be like, okay, when I approach this record, my voice gotta be demanding, like it has to cut through. Right. You know what I'm saying? In my mind, I'm always thinking about cutting through. Like when this person hear this song, this first come on, is this gonna make them turn their head? You know what I'm saying? Or is it gonna make them be like, oh, that's cool. I don't ever want that, oh, that's cool. I want that, oh my God, like, who is that singing?
Right. Exactly. And you know what's so crazy? When I first heard your voice, you know who I thought about, right?
Who?
So it was a mix between Bow Wow, Little Romeo, and Corey. And Sammy, too, actually.
Wow. That's the first time I've ever heard that.
You know why? Because you got that voice. Like, you know how they were superstars, right? Mm-hmm. And they were young. And it's like your voice and your singing. And it's things like that that I feel like we've been missing, especially young R&B artists. Right, we don't get that a lot.
Right.
Yeah, so... is that something that you was listening to when you was younger?
I came up to listening to Chris Brown, Usher. I love R&B, so like I literally listen to all artists that sing. I don't care who you are, I've heard your music. Like that's just a part of what I do. Like that's a part of my studying. Like, but I came up listening to, you know, Keith Sweat, Joe LaVert, Houdini. Who else are listening to? Just a plethora of dope R&B. You are Genuine, Tyrese, Tank. Like, I'm like, I really love R&B. I'm a real R&B singer. So like, me studying R&B means a lot to me.
Okay, that's dope. So I gotta ask you, what were the albums and songs that you were literally listening to and singing and practicing around the house? Because you know when you were an artist, there was that one song you was like, I gotta learn how to hit this note.
Right, right. I feel like it was the Chris Brown album. Chris Brown. You know, his first debut album. I know every record on there. Every record. Like, all of them. Young Love. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I be liking them records that like ain't like super popping. But like they like dope.
Exactly. You listen to the whole album.
Exactly.
Okay. I love that.
Yeah.
So what was your favorite to sing around the house? Like,
I would definitely say Young Love.
Okay. Why was that?
I just liked the way that he was singing in that. You know what I'm saying? And then Your Man Ain't Me.
That was
yeah,
I used
yeah.
to enjoy it right there.
Man, that he be acting all cocky like. What? Motherfucker was smash. Shout out to CB, man. For real.
Nah, that's what's up. Did you have any vocal training, or you just?
I really was born like this. I never really in middle school, I went to choir, and you know, I worked my craft there, and then once I got signed, I started working with Mama Jen, you know. Mm-hmm. But like, other than that, yeah, like I ain't really have no vocal training like that before. Like, it was just really just me going to school every day.
Oh wow. Okay, that's really great. So I see you got the song with Lil Baby about to drop. And sure. It's so crazy because one of my genuine questions for you was going to be like, who are the two artists you want to get on one record?
Now? Because now I got other goals. Like, I make vision boards.
Oh, okay. That's
so right. Like, I'll write down everything mm-hmm. that's going to happen in my life. And then like every day I wake up and I look at it and it happens. It really, wow. Everything happens. So. On my vision board now, I got it wrote down that I'm gonna work with Chris Brown.
Okay.
Chris Brown, for sure, we gotta get in there, we gotta do one. I feel like this is gonna happen genuinely though, because the music is just so dope, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But I think Chris Brown and Usher. For sure. Just that stuff from Usher alone is everything. You know, he fucked with my Climax Challenge, so I feel like now that I got records out, I gotta do one.
Now that means a lot. Like, what was your reaction when you seen that?
I was excited. I was like, what?
Right?
Usher is listening to my voice on his Instagram?
Yo, that's insane. I can't believe that.
Yeah, I was definitely super excited, for sure.
So dancing or singing came first? I'm assuming it's singing.
Singing for sure.
How did dancing come about?
I mean, I've always danced. Like, I had a lot of friends that know how to dance, and I always aspired to be, like, you know, an entertainer. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like just me hanging around a lot of dancers, going to parties with dancers, dancing with dancers, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, it just kind of rubbed off on me.
Okay, that's what's up. All right.
Yeah, man, you know, after we drop this record, man, March 4th, go get that. Make sure that y'all stay tuned for my project. I got a lot of new music on the way. Other than just that record. Yeah, man, just stay tuned, and make sure that y'all follow me on all social medias at Hylan Starr, HylanStarr.
Perfect.
I'm begging for that thing, so let's get this out the way. When we fuck, it ain't no pain. But I promise you one.